You used to be a cocktail waitress, right?
I don't know what you're talking about, Jack.
No, come on, because...
She's leading you... down some dangerous road.
No, I'm not. You used to... You had a scam of making money.
I didn't have to. I chose. It was a choice.
Yeah?
You know, with, I'm a hustler.
So what would you tell everyone? Tell everyone what you do.
Oh, goodness. You're going to make me do this. Well, okay. So, you know, I was a cocktail waitress, and sometimes... You know, people aren't nice to you, or, you know, it's a slow night, and so people smoke those terrible cigarettes, and,
yeah.
And there used to be cigarette machines, and people would put money in the cigarettes and pull the thing, and the cigarettes come down. Well, I figured out a way to jam up the machine so no one could get the cigarettes, and I used to bust open the back of the machine.
That was you, huh?
Take the cigarettes out, and then I would put them in my cocktail glass on my tray and sell individual cigarettes, and the later on in the evening it gets, people will pay anything
100%.
For a cigarette. Yeah. That's genius.
Smart. Yeah. Smart. See?
I did very well as a cocktail waitress. I was very innovative.
Yeah. The four of us in an escape room would just be perfect.
No concept. We'd crush it.
You'd be scamming. You'd be finding magnets. This guy's just being an ultimate badass. And I'd sort of just sing and, like, just try and keep everyone's spirits up. Adam, you never played baseball.
No.
But you're going to get a theme here, folks. You also used to run... you used to operate a scam outside of Fenway Park, which is where the Boston Red Sox play, right? Where, tell everyone what you did.
Wait a second.
First
of all, you look so
sweet. Just because you're wearing pink. She's got on, going to wear a baby sort of pink color, but we all know that you are just a scam for money.
Listen, it's Hollywood.
But this was in Boston. Appeared.
Yes, okay, so first of all, I have to correct you. It wasn't my scam. It wasn't my idea. I was just a 15-year-old kid trying to make a living, hustling, trying to make some money. And I got a job.
I think we've heard this before.
Sounds familiar, doesn't it? This pitch, this routine.
I got a job selling slush outside of Fenway Park. Which, you know, if you're selling slush outside of Fenway Park, you're going to do pretty well. Because there's, you know, hundreds of thousands of people pouring out of there on summer nights. So I just had a little ketchup bottle with some vodka in it, and I would sell special slush, and I could charge more for my special slush. Everybody was lining up at my cart. Nobody had anybody else their slush cart. Where did my slush cart had a line down the block?
But where were you getting the liquor at the age of 15?
Well,
because that's where it starts to become illegal.
The men who employed me owned the slush cart. It was their slush cart. It was their slush. It was their vodka bottle. It was their everything. And the Boston police, those fine men in blue.
I love it.
I bet they were first in line for the slush.
Yeah,
you can get past the ketchup and vodka.
There was no ketchup in the bottle. It was just an empty bottle.
That was the beer. That was the beer. It wasn't the
vodka.
It was in an empty bottle. And I used to do one pump or two. One pump or two.